we are asked to determine the domain and range of the given function, where the domain is a set of all possible inputs, and because we have a function of x, we can say the domain is a set of all possible x values, and the range is a set of all possible outputs, which are the y values or function values. Notice we are given a square root function, so the most important thing to remember here is that when we have a square root function, the radicand, or the number under the square root, must be non-negative, because if it was negative, we would have an imaginary number. So the restriction on this function is that the radicand, which is the expression 6 minus 3x, must always be greater than or equal to 0. So if we set up and solve the inequality 6 minus 3x is greater than or equal to 0, we can determine the domain of the given function. To solve the inequality, we first isolate the variable term by subtracting 6 on both sides of the inequality. Simplifying, 6 minus 6 is 0. We now have the inequality negative 3x greater than or equal to negative 6. The next step is to divide both sides by negative 3 to solve for x. But remember, when solving an inequality, if we multiply or divide both sides by a negative, we must reverse the inequality. So when we divide both sides by negative 3, the inequality changes from greater than or equal to less than or equal to. Simplifying, negative 3 divided by negative 3 is 1. 1 times x is x. We now reverse the inequality, so we now have less than or equal to. Negative 6 divided by negative 3 is positive 2. The domain of the given function is x less than or equal to 2. But let's also express the domain using interval notation. To do this, let's graph this interval on the number line. Because we have x is less than or equal to 2, 2 is in the interval, so we have a closed point on 2, and then an arrow to the left. As we move to the left of the number line, we approach negative infinity, which means for interval notation, we have the interval from negative infinity, comma, to positive 2. Because 2 is in the interval, we use a square bracket to the right of 2. And for negative infinity or positive infinity, we always use a parenthesis. So we have a parenthesis to the left of negative infinity. And now let's talk about the range of the given function. Remember, the range is the set of all possible outputs. Again, focusing on the square root, if we take the square root of a non-negative number, the smallest value we will ever get is 0, and then from there, the values will be larger. So notice how when the square root is equal to 0, the function value is going to be 2 times 0 plus 1, which is equal to positive 1. So positive 1 is the smallest function value of the given function, and then from there, the function values will increase, which means the range is y is greater than or equal to positive 1. To express the range using interval notation, we have the interval from 1 to positive infinity. The interval does include 1, so we have a square bracket to the left of 1, and we have a parenthesis to the right of infinity. Another way to find the domain and range is to analyze the graph of the given function. So let's verify the results graphically. Here we have the graph of the given function. To determine the domain, we want to project the function onto the x-axis or analyze the graph horizontally. Notice how the rightmost point of the function is this point here, where x is equal to positive 2. And then from here, the graph moves left indefinitely, which means the x values decrease indefinitely and approach negative infinity, which is the reason why the domain is x is less than or equal to 2, expressed using an inequality or interval notation. To determine the range graphically, we want to project the graph onto the vertical axis or y-axis, or analyze the graph vertically. Notice how the lowest point on the graph is this point here, where the y-value is positive 1, and then from here, notice how the graph moves up indefinitely, and the y values or function values approach positive infinity, which is the reason why the range is y is greater than or equal to 1, again expressed here using an inequality as well as interval notation. I hope you found this helpful.